CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 6.
Hello children, I am your friend Amit Kumar Thakur. I hope you are making fun at your home and besides this you are also studying at your home. In our last meeting, we talked about the first chapter of your history book, class 6. Today, we will talk about the second chapter on the trail of the earliest people, history book of class 6th. So, dear children, in this chapter, we will study in detail some aspects of the lives of the earliest people. The earliest people, why were they on the move? This is the first topic of your chapter. Dear children, our country is very ancient. People lived in this subcontinent as early as 2 million years ago. The earliest people were described as hunter-gatherers because they generally hunted wild animals, caught fish and birds, and also gathered fruits, roots, nuts, seeds, leaves, stalks, and eggs for their food. The earliest people living in this subcontinent were lucky as they could get immense variety of plants in a tropical land like ours. Do you think that it was an easy task to work as a hunter-gatherer? Mind you, dear children, it was a very, very difficult task. There are several animals that run faster than us. Many that are stronger than us. The earliest people needed to be alert, quick, and have lots of presence of mind to hunt animals or catch fish and birds. Similarly, they needed to have the knowledge of edible parts of the plants and the knowledge about the season when the fruits ripen to collect plant produce. So, dear children, do you think that you have this knowledge? I know most of us don't have this knowledge, so the life of earliest people was very, very difficult. Dear children, please recall your last journey. What purpose did you travel for? Do you think that earliest people also traveled to different places? What might be the purposes for which the earliest people traveled? The hunter-gatherers also moved from place to place. They moved for different purposes. And we can list out those purposes. Number one, first purpose, if they had stayed at one place for a long time, they would have eaten up all the available plant and animal resources. Therefore, they would have had to go elsewhere in search of food. This is the first purpose. The second purpose was, animals move from place to place, either in search of smaller prey or in search of grass and leaves. That is why those who hunted then had to follow their movements. The third purpose was, plants and trees bear fruit in different seasons. People may have moved from season to season in search of different kinds of plants. The fourth purpose was, people, plants, and animals need water to survive. People living at the banks of rivers, lakes, and streams would have to go in search of water during the dry seasons. And the dry seasons were winter and summer seasons. The fifth purpose of the movement of earliest people was, people may have traveled to meet their friends and relatives. So these are the purposes for which earliest people traveled. Children, now we come on the second topic of the chapter. How do we know about these people? Dear children, you must be wondering, how do we know about these earliest people who were hunter-gatherers? We know about them through the things hunter-gatherers made and used, which have been found by the archaeologists. It is likely that hunter-gatherers made and used tools of stone, wood, and bone, of which stone tools have survived best. What were these tools used for? The stone tools were used to, number one, to cut meat and bone, number two, to scrape bark from trees and hides, that is animal skins, number three, to chop fruits and roots, number four, some tools may have been attached to handles of bone or wood to make spears and arrows for hunting. Number five, other tools were used to chop wood, which was used as firewood and to make huts and tools. Number six, stone tools may also have been used for digging the ground to collect edible roots. And number seven, the tools were also used for stitching clothes made out of animal skin. So, dear children, you can see how tools were important for hunter-gatherers. Choosing a place to live in. This is another topic of your chapter. Dear children, can you imagine which places were chosen by the hunter-gatherers to live in? If you look at map 2 in your book, you will find many such places. Bhimbetka in Madhya Pradesh, Hunsgi in Karnataka, and Kurnool Caves in Telangana are important among them. The hunter-gatherers chose places to live in which were near sources of water or where good quality stone was available. You know that they made tools out of stones. So, a site where good quality stones were available was important for the hunter-gatherers. You know, places where stone was found and where people made tools are known as factory sites. You must be wondering, how do we know where these factory sites were? We identify those sites as factories where we find blocks of stone, tools that were made and perhaps discarded because they were not perfect, and chips of waste stones left behind at these sites. Such factory sites where people lived for longer spells of time are called habitation cum factory sites. Some sites such as Bhimbetka in Madhya Pradesh are places where people lived. These are known as habitation sites. These include caves and rock shelters. People choose these natural caves because they provided shelter from rain, heat, and wind. Natural caves and rock shelters are found in the Vindhyas and the Dakkan Plateau. These rock shelters are close to the Narmada Valley, so enough water was available here. So, dear children, now you have understood that there were three types of sites. Number one, the habitation sites where earliest people only live. Number two, the factory sites where they manufactured their tools. And number 3, the habitation cum factory site. Names and date is the another topic of your chapter. Dear children, you must know that archaeologists have given lengthy names for the time that we are studying. Time has been divided into following periods. Number 1, Paleolithic period. This comes from the two Greek words, paleo means old and lithos meaning stone. It extends from 2 million years ago to about 12,000 years ago. This long period is divided into the lower, middle, and upper Paleolithic. This long span of time covers 99% of human history. The period when we find environmental changes beginning about 12,000 years ago till about 10,000 years ago is called the Mesolithic period, that is Middle Stone Age. Stone tools found during this period are generally tiny and are called microliths. Micro means small and liths means stone. The next stage from about 10,000 years ago is known as the Neolithic Age. Neo means new and lithic means stone. So it is the stage of new stone. So children, I hope now you have understood the division of time into different periods. Okay children, first of all, you must understand that what are sites. You must know the meaning of the term site as is used in history. Sites are places where the remains of things like tools, pots, buildings, etc. were found. These were made, used, and left behind by people. These may be found on the surface of the earth, buried under the earth, or sometimes even under water. Making stone tools is another topic of your chapter. Dear children, I know that you were curious to know how stone tools were made. Stone tools were probably made using two different techniques. The first technique is called stone on stone technique. Here, the pebbles from which the tool was to be made was held in one hand. Another stone, which was used as a hammer, was held in the other hand. The second stone was used to strike off flakes from the first till the required shape was obtained. The second technique was called pressure flaking technique. Here, the core was placed on a firm surface. The hammer stone was used on a piece of bone or stone that was placed on the core to remove flakes that could be shaped into tools. So children, I hope you have understood the two techniques of making tools. Finding out about fire. This is another topic of your chapter. Dear children, you must know that the hunter-gatherers were familiar with the use of fire. Traces of ash have been found in Kurnool. Fire could have been used for many things like number 1, as a source of light, number 2, to roast meat, and number 3, to scare away animals. So children, just tell me, what purposes do you use fire for? A changing environment. It is your next topic. Dear children, around 12,000 years ago, there were major changes in the climate of the world, with a shift to relatively warm conditions. In many areas, this led to development of grasslands. This led to an increase in the number of animals that survived on grass. Those who hunted these animals now followed them, learning about their food habits and their breeding seasons. It is likely that this helped people to start thinking about herding and rearing these animals themselves. Fishing also became important. This was also a time when several grain-bearing grasses, including wheat, barley, and rice, grew naturally in different parts of the subcontinent. Men, women, and children probably collected these grains as food and learned where they grew and when they ripened. This may have led them to think about growing plants on their own. So, children, you can see the changing environment led to the beginning of cattle rearing and agriculture. Rock painting and what they tell us is the another topic of your chapter. Dear children, now let's talk about some cultural aspects of the life of hunter-gatherers. Many of the caves in which these early people lived have paintings on the walls. Some of the best examples are from Madhya Pradesh and southern Uttar Pradesh. These paintings show wild animals drawn with great accuracy and skill. These paintings show the scenes of hunting, etc. So, painting might be a favorite time pass of the earliest people. It might be a ritual also that was performed before going for hunting. Who did what? It is another topic of your chapter. Dear children, what work is done by your mummy and what work is done by your papa in your home? Is there any clear division of labor in your home? Now let's talk about the division of labor among men and women among earliest people. Earliest people hunted, gathered plant produce, made stone tools, and painted on cave walls. Is there any way of finding out whether women hunted or men made stone tools, whether women painted or men gathered fruits and nuts? At present, we don't really know. However, there are at least two possibilities. It is likely that both men and women may have done many of these things together. It is also possible that some tasks were done only by women and others only by men. And again, there could have been different practices in different parts of the subcontinent. A closer look at Hunsgi. It is another topic of your chapter. Dear children, now we will have a closer look at Hunsgi, which is in Karnataka. A number of early Paleolithic sites were found here. At some sites, a large number of tools used for all sorts of activities were found. These were probably habitation cum factory sites. In some of the other smaller sites, there is evidence to suggest that tools were made. Some of the sites were close to springs. Most tools were made from limestone, which was locally available. So, sites like Hunsgi give us a deeper understanding of the lives of the hunter-gatherers. Dear children, I would also like to tell you one interesting fact. Nowadays, ostriches are found in Australia. But do you know that ostriches were found in India during the Paleolithic period? Yes, it's true. Now, children, it's quiz time, your favorite segment of our program. Okay, let's start our quiz. Number one, the first question. What material was used for making tools in Hunsgi? And your options are A. Wood, B. Bricks, C. Limestone, and D. Iron. Very easy question. I think all of you have given the correct answer. Yes, it is option C, limestone. So, in Hunsgi, the tools were made of limestones. The second question, where did early people paint? And your options are on the walls of caves, B, on trees, C, on earth, D, on stone tools. And it is again a very simple question, and many of you have given the correct answer. Yes, it is option A, on the walls of caves. Now we move on the next question. When did grasslands develop? And your options are around 5,000 years ago, B, around 10,000 years ago, C, around 20,000 years ago, and D, around 12,000 years ago. Yes, many of you have given the correct answer. Yes, it is option D, around 1200 years ago. Now we move on to another question. Why did hunter-gatherers choose to live in caves and rocks shelters? And your options are A. They were warm, B. They were cold, C. They provided shelter from the rain, heat, and wind, and D. They protected early men from the wild animals. So, dear children, what is the correct answer? Yes, it is option C. They provided shelter from the rain, heat, and wind. Now, another question for you is, why did hunter-gatherers travel from place to place? We have discussed this in detail in our discussion. Can you remember? Okay, I will tell you the answer. The hunter-gatherers move from place to place, number one, in search of food, number two, to follow the movements of animal they hunted, number three, to find out fruits in different seasons, number four, in search of water during the dry season, and number five, to meet their friends and relatives. Now we move on to another question. List three ways in which hunter-gatherers used fire. How many of you can answer this question? We have discussed it in detail in our discussion. Okay, yes, I will give you the correct answer, and you must remember. The hunter-gatherers used fire for three purposes. Number one, as a source of light. Number two, to roast meat. And number three, to scare away wild animals. Now, children, tell me, would you use fire for any of these purposes today? I know most of us use fire for cooking food today in our homes. Now we move on to another question. How did the ancient people travel? And your options are A. By buses, B. By trains, C. By ships, and D. On foot. And many of you can give correct answer very easily, and yes, it is D. The ancient people traveled on foot. Now we move on to another question. Who had found the things which were made and used by the hunters? And your options are A. Astrologists, B. Archaeologists, C. Psychologists, and D. None of these. And yes, yes, you have rightly pointed out, it is correct answer is B. Archaeologist. Now we move to another question. In the ancient times, tools were made up of which material? and your options are A. Stone, B. Wood, C. Bone, and D. All of this. So, what is the correct answer? Yes, the correct answer is D. All of these. Now, we move on another question. For which purposes were the stone tools used? A. To cut meat and bone. B. To chop fruits and roots. C. To make spear and arrows. And D. All of these. And what is the correct answer? I think all of you have found it. Yes, it is D. All of these. Now the next question is, places where the people made tools were known as A. Factory sites, B. Residence sites, C. Habitation sites, and D. None of these. So what is your answer, children? Yes, many of you have correctly given it. It is A. The factory sites. Another question for you. By which technique were the stone tools made? A. Stone on stone technique. B. Pressure flaking. C. Both A and B. And D. None of these. So what is the correct answer? Yes, it is C. Both A and B is the correct answer. Another question is, what did indicate the finding of ash? The options are A. Water, B. Ice, C. Fire, and D. All of these. So what is the correct answer? Yes, all of you have given the correct answer. It is C. Fire. The next question is, for what purpose did the men, women, and children collect the grains? Options are A. For food, B. For growing crops, C. Both A and B, and D. None of these. So what is the correct answer? Yes, it is C. Both A and B. Next question is, in which state were the eggs of ostrich found? The options are A. Maharashtra, B. Madhya Pradesh, C. Delhi, and D. Noida. So what is the correct answer? Yes, many of you have given it rightly. It is A. Maharashtra. Another question is, in which site were a large number of tools used for all sorts of activity found? The options are habitation site, B. Factory site, C. Habitation cum factory site, and D. None of these. Yes, many of you have given the correct answer. It is option C. Habitation cum factory site. And the last question is, when was the Mesolithic period? And your options are A. 6,000 to 700 years ago, B. 7,000 to 8,000 years ago, C. 8,000 to 9,000 years ago, and D. 12,000 to 10,000 years ago. And what is the correct answer, dear children? Yes, it is D. 12,000 to 10,000 years ago. So, dear children, with this, we have completed this second chapter of your history book of class 6. I hope you have liked this quiz also. It will help you a lot to continue your studies even remaining at home. Play, sing, dance, and enjoy a lot. But also keep your focus on your study. I, Amit Kumar Thakur, your friend, will meet you in the next program. Till then, tata, bye-bye.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta, and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and Shanu Muksim. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.